Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with the final video for the Death Stalker and the biohazard post-nuclear base. We have finished it. Actually, I'm lying about that. We haven't finished it. We are missing a couple of little details, but that's okay. We are going to wait and then add them in due time when we feel it. But it's just a little blood spatter left on the Death Stalker itself, but it's not a big deal. So here it is, and the water, of course, is curing, and I already performed the much needed surgery there, added a few more pebbles here and there, and the resin should be cured by tomorrow or Wednesday, and it's perfectly fine now. But you know, we don't want to mess around too much because we don't want dust and or lint or anything like that to fall on it. Anyway, in the coming weeks, we will be featuring different models on this base, in part just because, as you very well know, we like to do that. But you know, we want to thank all the subscribers, all the cranky heads out there who through your kindest words offered moral support and a lot of great cheerleading. We want to thank Ken Hamilton for sending us the burnt out piston in the head zombie figure. And then we also want to thank a few of our sponsors, i.e., in no particular order, of course, Ammo by Mig Jimenez, Iwata, and their great Neo for Iwata, and Uschi van der Rosten and Alex, who runs that entire operation, and of course Alex Vallejo of Vallejo Acrylics, and also some good friends over at Games Workshop, including Phil, who keeps the inspiration going here in the laboratory with his own amazing breakthrough techniques and builds. And anyway, let's see, am I brave? What if I drop it? Yeah, that would be a laughing matter, wouldn't it? Whoa, we're doing it this way. All right, parents, watch out. We're moving it to the other side. By now, you know, it's kind of not for children under the age of 13, I guess, even though I get the feeling most of these children are already playing fairly violent video games. But, you know, we mean it when we say parental guidance advice at this point. All right, we're moving over. Here we go. There we go. Yes, that is one. Let's see how close we can get here. Hey, we can get pretty close. I love all of that cigar ash. For those of you looking for similar effect with your burnout vehicles, get somebody who smokes cigars to save you the ashes. One cigar will give you lots and lots of ashes, or you can get some cigarettes and or look for an ashtray somewhere and empty it, which would be a very weird thing. Isn't this hobby fun? Anyway, we are really pleased, people, folks, the peeps out there, the cranky heads, with the way this one turned out. So I'm going to put it back just because we don't want to test. We don't want to tempt the fates. But anyway, we had a great time building this one. And again, we want to thank everybody for watching along. And, we hope that you go back through and enjoy the entire sequence of this build. There's going to be an extra Cranky Treat chapter added to the zombie book, which I am working hard at writing, and that'll be included in the Cranky book, which I hope will come out in either late April or early May. So All right, my friends, keep up the great inspiration. Remember, inspiration is a two-way street. All right, more Cranky Show. Kill those zombies. Yes. Woo!